Welcome back to the Howe Podcast 101. I am your co-host, Jake Roberts, joined alongside
other co-host, Lucas Mitchell, and we're also joined by our engineer,
Noah Riley.
And so, you may have noticed, we have some extra lights that is going to be accompanying us. So.
Today, at least. I don't know about permanently. We'll see.
Permanently.
We can't steal them. They are my brothers, so.
Sure.
So.
Anyway, this video is sponsored by
Hannah's Cafe and Market. Dawn Smokehouse, Medford Chiropractic and Family Wellness at 2412 Old Mother Road.
Dang.
JA Autos, FBC Howe for the Fantastic Studios.
Yeah.
And that's it.
Okay.
We have open ad slots, by the way. I feel like that music's too loud now. Is that just me?
Yes. It probably is.
It was just you.
Anyway, okay. Spooky Halloween, October the 30th at downtown.
Okay.
Downtown Howe.
Yeah.
I don't know. Just in that four-way intersection, you know what I mean?
Yep.
You guys know where it's at.
It's gonna be a great time.
Yeah,
like where they do Founders Day and stuff.
Have we even signed up yet?
Yeah, we're signed up.
Oh yeah, that's right.
We're good to go.
Yeah.
Next Saturday.
Also on the 31st of October, we're also going to have a trunk or treat at FBC Howe, and we're gonna be just there.
Yeah,
I don't know. You'll find us. We'll hand out candy.
It's gonna be a great time.
We're gonna make up a game. We're gonna be dressed really stupidly. You know, the regular drill.
Yep.
So email is howepodcast101@outlook.com. You can email us about school activities, anything about basketball, volleyball, football, and band. Also, band made sick, but we'll cover that.
That's for a different time. I knew you were going to do the applause.
So also, we have our website, how101.com. Oh, gosh. .com, where you can find our merch.
Is my mic too quiet? Is that just me?
I don't know.
Is that just me, Noah? Why does it sound so quiet?
Okay. Right now, everything is just Jake.
True.
Okay, as he turns it up. Okay. All right.
What
a mean engineer.
So merch. You can
donate.
And give us
some
money.
Okay. We really need some new tradition. It's getting really old, but you know.
It's 50th episode is coming up.
Which means season two. Which means there will. Are we going to go to 50 episodes? Or are we going to go to 49 and then start season two?
50. I think 50. We're going to celebrate 50. Because we didn't really celebrate our first our 1 year anniversary.
Yeah, our 1 year stuff. Yeah.
We'll celebrate it alongside it.
Yeah. So, segments for today.
Yeah.
We do not have an interview for you. I apologize for that. It's been a
hectic
week. We've had interviews like a month in a row.
Yeah.
So you're welcome. Plus, setting up interviews is a lot harder than you'd think. Next week
messes up everything.
We may, maybe. Have Tom Miller on from KXII. Well,
used to
be from KXII, but maybe. So we're trying to get that worked out for you. I am not these losers who never set up interviews.
Hey, I ask.
You ask.
I got Kira, you know, and Corey, and you know, the biggest interviews there.
What a pro! Yeah, you're right.
Okay. Our segments are going to be House Howe next. Then we have top 10, and we're going to be cutting it short. No interview, and we're going to be doing our...
We'll just have enough time for one more thing. Like usual. I mean, we usually have at least enough time for one more thing.
Yeah.
Actually, always.
And also make sure you guys like, subscribe, hit that
notification button.
Bell, there you go. So you don't miss one of our videos. You can also comment down below anything.
Seriously, comment, guys.
Comment down.
We love to see your comments.
If you comment down below and really hit that like button,
I'm kind of concerned why Noah's just staring off at the camera on the side. No, first off, you want to show them the camera? You want to show them your excellent view?
Don't really.
Well, I'll do it.
No.
Okay, he'll do it. He'll do it next segment. Coming up next, we're going to take a look at Dallas Cowboys, victories,
and
got some NFL crap that we're going to cover.
And a ton of house stuff.
And a ton of house stuff. I don't even know what to call this segment, but whatever it is, we'll do it right after this.
First Baptist Church of Howe services on Sunday morning is an awesome place to be, with Bible fellowship and a main service for everyone. The main service consists of worship by Art Rayburn and a sermon by Roger Tidwell. The fellowships begin at 9:15 for the adults, youth, and kids to enjoy the teachings of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. The main service also starts at 10:30 after the fellowships. During these uncertain times, the First Baptist Church of Howe has your back on 100 Davis Street in Howe, Texas.
Hey Lucas, who's your favorite chiropractor?
Rachel Medford, of course.
Medford Chiropractic has the best chiropractic service in Texas, but they also have the best massages, and more.
They have massages?
Yeah, and they are awesome.
Yeah, you can find more information on MedfordChiroTX.com.
That's MedfordChiroTX.com.
Medford Chiropractic and Family Wellness at 2412 Old North Road.
940-535-7067.
That is their phone number. And Dr. Rachel Medford, awesome personality, and she's a great person.
Dak, again, your assignment is simple. You know, you'd like 50 yards. You don't really need that many. Prescott play action, back to throw, a little screen out to the right to Schultz for five, to the 41, second down, a little pass, slant to Cooper, first down across the 50. To the 49-yard line, stopped by Jackson. Hand off Pollard, coming left, block from Tyron Smith. Pollard across the 45. Down to the 41-yard line. Second and short, little flare pass to Lamb with a block out in front from Cooper. First down to the 35. Wait, if you stop and listen real closely, you will hear the gears in Kellen Moore's brain grinding. They are turning. There's smoke coming out of his ears.
I'm vengeance.
Looking down the field, Lamb! 10, 5, victory! Cowboys win! The ghosts are exorcised!
Welcome back to the Howe Podcast 101. I'm your co-host Jake Roberts, joined alongside
other co-host Lucas Mitchell, and we also are joined by our engineer
Noah Riley.
And so what you just heard from there was Cowboys game.
It was the final overtime Cowboys victory parade party. Ghost exercising, CeeDee Lamb, Dak Prescott.
Vengeance.
Insane. Beating the New England Patriots. Touchdown pass from Dak to CeeDee Lamb. 35 yards for the victory for them. So I do quickly want to discuss the Cowboys. They are a hot topic. They're 5-1.
They are on their way to the Super Bowl.
No, they're not. That's
it's
early.
It's up
that's,
in the air.
It's early to say. I think they're on their way to
the playoffs.
They're on their way to the NFC Championship. I think.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that's fair. But I think as far as this goes, Lucas is jamming out here.
Good music.
It is good music. Comment down below your favorite song that we play. Yeah. Not that they know the names, but whatever. Okay. So, yeah. Noah, I'd like you to give your thoughts on the Cowboys. So just go ahead and give me your favorite thing about this team. Like the best part of this team.
And they're very, very high-powered offense.
You didn't switch the camera.
That'd be very.
Why are you like?
He's just stubborn today. He's fine.
He's just stubborn today.
It's fine.
Wow. Okay.
I don't want to switch the camera because I'm wearing a white T-shirt.
No one cares.
Okay. No. My favorite part about the Cowboys is their incredibly high-powered offense.
And not switching the camera.
And that.
Okay.
What's your favorite part?
Trayvon Diggs. And, I actually have a little...
My favorite is Dak Prescott.
I have a little something for all you that are fans of Trayvon Diggs.
Is one way or another, this is going to be a real growing situation for the Cowboys for the rest of this year.
Fine.
Is it copyrighted?
Nah.
Jones fires it over the middle, and there's Diggs with the deflected interception left sideline. 10, 5, of course it's Diggs. Why, of course it's Diggs.
Trayvon. I have a question, Jake.
Yeah, go ahead.
Did you make that?
I did not make that.
You did not.
I could have made
found
that.
Found it, like, off
I just,
YouTube.
I found it, yeah. Credit to Dallas Cowboys Radio Network for that, actually. No, well, the...
Wow,
we
credit to someone who gets millions and millions of views.
Yeah, we still got to credit to them. They can copyright us. They really could.
Yes. I'm going to sue these kids, these 16-year-olds.
Yeah, I know. Actually, probably not. It's unlikely.
Noah's the only 15-year-old here. Youngin.
That's why he doesn't want to switch the camera, because he's young.
Yeah. Okay. Little baby boy.
All right. Who wants to get into some Howe Bulldogs?
Yeah. I can't wait to talk about it. Okay. I was actually really excited about Friday.
We're going to switch the music up for this. So, okay. B. Give me B. There we go. That's the How Bulldogs vibe. Go ahead, Lucas. Let's kick this off. And you just explain you're in band. And a band has made it to state, right?
So yes, but we'll get that. We'll do the football game. Okay. Noah, do you know anything about volleyball?
Probably not.
I would assume so.
I know.
Your parents go
you
to
can
like
pull up the Howe Enterprise.
They played Leonard on.
They win or lose
Friday.
Did they win or lose? Do you have any idea?
I think I heard they lose. I
cannot tell you that for sure. Okay. I know JV.
Because I remember Talia came back, and I don't remember if they won or not.
I know that JV won.
Okay.
Tell you that much. I'll look it up right now.
Yeah.
All right. So, for the football game on Friday,
yes,
the one against
Mineola,
right?
Yellow Jackets, except their stadium's orange, which was really confusing, by the way. They were orange, but they're the Mineola Yellow Jackets.
Yeah.
I don't know. It was a bit odd to me, but you know, it worked for them, and that's kind of all that matters.
Mineola. A lot of the guys on the football team, on their football team, were just tanks. All right.
Okay.
They just.
Did you see that running back? Did you see the 99-yard touchdown?
Oh my gosh! I remember seeing that. You should have seen the entire band.
It was
like, bruh. A lot of people were just not looking. I'm like, Ethan, look. And Ryan was also looking. I'm like, look.
Oh my
gosh. They just did the entire field. I just ran the entire field, and
that's crazy.
A lot of that happened a lot, though.
I know. That running back has offers from Baylor, Arkansas.
Why did we even go 2 hours?
And
2 hours to get beat.
I think that's it. Sorry, guys.
Okay, so Band did not amazing at the Mineola game. We didn't
do
pretty
that
good. Great.
I heard y'all.
It wasn't our best performance, though, and... It's not great to not see your best performance.
Yeah.
Mineola actually said they didn't do that great of a job either.
Okay,
but
so I'm just going to say, Mineola's band was awesome.
Insane, yeah.
When they played the Texas...
They were in a different area. They would have been top five with us.
They did a good job. I mean, it sounded like it was the Longhorns. It sounded like I was at a Texas game.
They've got a really good band.
They do. They have a solid band.
The only thing I did not like about going to Mineola that day was there's two things. One is that
it's way too far away. It's literally
two hours away.
It's in East Texas.
Actually, a little over 2 hours away because we had to go on bus.
It's in East Texas.
Yeah, and everything, the entire thing was downhill. So
like the field's downhill.
Well, like you know how it goes. There's like the center.
It was a dome. Honestly,
dome,
though, cool. That stadium was sick.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
It was surrounded
but
by, like,
the only problem
trees.
With it was we had to navigate through a bunch of people going downhill, going around a bunch of roads that were garbage.
Did you see the Howe Enterprise up there?
I didn't. I wasn't looking.
You didn't? You, like, walked right by them.
We didn't really have time.
But you literally, like, walked right by them.
Too bad.
Jonathan slapped me on the back. He just passed me. So, yeah. And then I told him to tell you that you lost the game, and he just yelled it out.
Dang.
So...
Okay. Yeah, but we went through.
Oh, do you have the info? And please switch the camera this time.
All of the marimbas and stuff that go through.
So, for volleyball, I can't switch cameras. I'm on Howe Enterprise. Okay, so they lost in 4 sets to Leonard. Varsity did.
What was the score?
Okay.
Well, there's not really a score. The fourth set was 25-14.
Well, that explains it.
Yeah.
Okay. Disappointing, obviously, but...
And there's also basketball, just a little side note.
Noah, I'll let you explain the basketball, because you play basketball, actually,
yes,
for Howe. And
I do.
Could you actually, you know, switch the camera this time? You can do this. I believe in
do
you.
It.
It's a white t-shirt. No one cares. You got this.
So what do you want me to explain?
Basketball. You said there was, like, some scrimmage or something that's coming up?
Oh, yes. There is a scrimmage, Howe basketball versus Plano East.
Okay.
So let's just say this. They're 6A, right?
Yep.
Oh.
And their JV has 2 6-foot-8 kids.
Can they dunk?
Yeah.
Their JV has 2 kids that can dunk.
Yes, they toss up alley-oops.
So you guys are going to get... I understand it's a scrimmage, but you guys are going to get destroyed.
We're probably going to lose, but I think JV... Because varsity's playing a mix of the JVA and their varsity. And then... JV is playing their JVB. So we might beat their JVB.
You're on JV.
Yes.
Right. Okay. So, well, you have a chance. Maybe.
They are 6A. They are 6A.
Yeah. That's a lot more A's than you.
Yes.
A lot
more. That's A's. Three more.
Three more A's.
Oh.
So kind of stacked against us, but you know.
Whitesboro. Look, their band looks like a 5A.
Really?
Because it looks like they have as many guard
kids
as
they have a lot of people.
Yeah. It looked like their guard had 20 times as much people as we did, which we had like 6. So they had a lot of people. I'm really surprised that they got away with 3A. I don't really understand it.
Well, there's redistricting at the end of this year. And football hopefully moves down. Because if we move down, wouldn't you rather play Whitesboro and Leonard?
And Whiteright.
Whiteright, S&S, Bells.
Yeah.
And all these powerhouse teams in East Texas, 90 miles away from where we live. I would. I know I would. So quickly, before we end this segment, how plays Bonham next week?
Hey, before we end the segment, we haven't even talked about state band.
True. Well, we might need an entire segment for that.
No.
Okay.
Anyway, so Saturday we went to Denton at the Collins Stadium, and we made the band made finals, which we did one of our best performance then, and then went to finals, and we even played even better.
Except, so how do you judge like how you play better? Like right. How does that work?
So
you just
actually,
like it just sounds better.
There's 4 judges, 2 of them are marching and 2 of them are music. Now, on finals they switch places, so the 2 judges that were judging marching go to music, and the music judges go to marching.
Yeah, makes sense.
So they can rank us differently.
So what were the scores?
So basically, at the beginning we were actually 3rd overall. And then we went to state on the finals.
Yeah,
as
4th overall.
Fourth
place,
so
okay.
Overall,
solid.
And
solid
honestly,
stuff.
I can tell that the judges really like. I could definitely understand why the judges would rank us differently, especially Pilot Point got 3rd, which
were they
probably
good?
They were one of my favorites.
Were they better than y'all? Like if you have to say, and I know that's tough.
Pilot Point really didn't have like the great, their visuals weren't the greatest, but I really liked their pit. Their pit made it above ours for sure. If you saw their pit, you would understand why.
Yeah.
They had a lot less energy than we did, but they definitely
how
played
tired
way
you
better.
Got back.
Pretty tired.
Noah, how tired was Bren?
I was like, I didn't even see her. They got back up.
Did
like
you see her
12.
This morning?
Yeah.
How tired was she this morning?
I don't know. I didn't take note.
You didn't.
I was very tired this morning.
That's just how caring you are.
Yeah.
I was kind of like, oh, I'll just go to church because I was gonna skip youth, and I'm like,
yeah,
I have a lot more energy than I really think I do. So
you always have more energy than you think. I think that's gonna do it for this segment. Are we good?
Yeah.
All right, that's gonna do it for this segment. Coming up next, it's time for top 10. We'll do it right after this.
Don's Smokehouse is one of the best butcher shops in Texas, but it's not just a butcher shop. It's home of the best beef jerky around and the famous Great Wall of Jerky, where you will find 17 different kinds of jerky, including bear, buffalo, elk, venison, turkey, and of course, beef and more. We are open Tuesdays through Saturdays from 10 to 6. Don's Smokehouse is located in downtown Howe at 111 East Hanning Street. Come on down for a free sample and experience the Great Wall of Jerky. Don's Smokehouse, the best jerky around.
Give it just a second, guys. Welcome back to the Howe Podcast 101. I am your co-host, Jake Roberts, joined alongside
other co-host, Lucas Mitchell, joined by engineer
Noah Riley. There we go. That's music good. Hey, who's ready for top 10?
I'm ready for top 10.
I'm always ready for a good top 10.
This is a pretty good top 10.
Is it a good top 10? Okay. Here's your goal. Your goal is to see how many of these players that you actually know.
None of them.
Actually, you'll know these.
I probably know like the top. I'll probably know like four players.
You'll know most of these players.
Dak Prescott.
Not even close.
Not on the list.
Let's kick it off with number 10.
All right, number 10.
All right, okay, what is this list, by the way?
It's top 10 NFL players, period.
Okay.
NFL.
All time.
All time.
All time. Let's go.
Number 10, a running back from the Detroit Lions.
Barry Sanders.
Correct.
You don't know who this is, but if you ever get bored, look up Barry Sanders' highlights. This man was insane. He destroyed people's ankles. Have you ever looked up Barry Sanders' highlights, Noah?
Is this Drunken Sailor?
That is Drunken Sailor, yeah.
Yeah, but it's NFL. It's
NFL Drunken Sailor.
It's called Up As She Rises.
Well, yeah, that's what we kind of saw.
But yeah. But it's like NFL version. Okay, yeah, so Barry Sanders is really good. What do you think? Do you think the placement on the list is good?
Yeah. Compared to the rest of these players, I'd say yes.
Okay, who's number 9?
Number 9 is Johnny Unitas.
Ooh, legendary quarterback from the 60s.
Never heard of him.
Yeah, I assume you wouldn't know.
60s, dude.
From the 60s.
Was I born then?
Yeah. This man was a straight legend. A straight baller legend.
Was he a baller, though? Like an absolute baller or like just a baller?
Absolute. Dude, this man, he was the first good quarterback to ever exist. He was the first.
There's never quarterbacks back then?
Well, there were. But he was the first, like, quarterback that passed the best.
Yeah.
The rest of them ran more.
Oh.
And, yeah, so he's solid. He's really, really solid.
Big
like,
solid man.
Big solid. Okay, number 8.
All right, number 8 is the quarterback for the Indianapolis Colts, Peyton Manning.
Hey.
Oh, wait, technically Johnny Unitas was also the quarterback.
Him.
He was the Baltimore Colts.
Yeah, Baltimore Colts.
Do you know that?
Yeah.
Peyton
Manning.
I think he needs to go higher than this.
I knew you'd say that.
No, but I think he does.
This man is a diehard Peyton Manning fan.
I'm not as much as I used to be. Not even close. I do like
Back Peyton. In my day.
Yeah, back in my day, I was a big Peyton Manning fan. I'm not going to lie to you there. This music is epic. I did like Peyton Manning, but I think he deserves higher. Right? I mean, he has all these records. He has 2 Super Bowls.
Once again, compared to the rest of these players, I wouldn't say so.
We'll see. But I think Peyton Manning deserves to be higher than this. I would say 5 or 4.
Because you also got to think about popularity. Just because they're...
Yeah, that's true. That's
just because their stats are better than another person's doesn't mean they weren't more popular for a better play.
Yeah, for sure. And Peyton Manning was as popular as it gets.
Yeah.
Like, top notch.
Okay. Something I always thought was funny. Peyton Manning looks like the most unathletic, uncoordinated guy
I've ever lived. I've seen him before.
Like, his neck, his forehead's like 5 times the size of my forehead. But yet the man has more money, more records than you'll ever hold.
My mom.
He does have more than your mom. He also has a bigger forehead than your mom and all of our moms, probably combined. Probably combined. But the man's a legend, and he continues to be a legend of the day. So, number 7.
Number 7 is Reggie White.
Okay, why is Peyton Manning not above Reggie White?
Because this man is a Super Bowl champion.
Okay.
He is a 2
There's a lot of Super Bowl champions.
I bet these players are all Super Bowl champions.
Does he have 6 rings?
He is a 2-time AP NFL Defensive Player of the Year and a 13-time Pro Bowler.
Read Peyton Manning stats.
A Pro Bowler?
Peyton Manning stats. Pro Bowler. He has 2 Super Bowls, 5-time MVP, 2-time NFL Offensive Player of the Year, and holds holds several major passing records.
Exactly. How many MVPs did he have?
5.
Oh.
But Reggie White was a beast.
Yeah, but defensive player and MVP is 2 different things. MVP is like everyone.
But was he popular? That's
why Reggie White was very popular, but not Peyton Manning popular.
He's first team all pro.
How many times? Once?
Yeah.
Okay, well,
and
Peyton Manning was...
No, 13. No.
19.
Hold on.
20. 21.
Oh, yeah, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 times.
Okay. Yeah. I bet Peyton was a little more than that, but whatever.
It was Reggie White.
Okay, number 6.
Joe Montana.
What? He's only number 6?
Yeah.
Dude.
Who's Joe?
Joe Montana. No, this man, this man is better than Tom Brady. Yes. You can tell me what you want.
Tom Brady has 7 Super Bowls.
It's not about the Super Bowls, and this man had 4.
It's not about the Super Bowl. It's about the message.
I'll read you Tom Brady's stats when he gets there.
Yeah, I know they're crazy.
When he gets there.
But you know he played in an era where quarterback stats weren't the same that they are now, because it was the 80s, right?
Yeah.
And it wasn't the same back then. But read me his stats for me, will you?
Okay. 4-time Super Bowl champion, 3-time Super Bowl MVP, 2-time NFL MVP, and holds several passing records. In the Super Bowl passing records.
Yeah. So, he was more of a clutch. A lot of people called him, I don't remember what his nickname was. Super Joe, maybe? I don't know.
Super Joe Mama.
No, he was clutch. He was one of the most clutch quarterbacks of all time. And I guess we haven't gotten to running backs and receivers yet and tight ends and all these other positions.
Yeah.
But I believe that he's number one. I believe he's the best NFL player to exist, period.
Ever in the entire world.
Ever, maybe beside Jim Brown. I'll give Jim Brown his space because he was a legend himself. But we'll see. I'm sorry if I sound a little weird. My nose is a little bit clogged, guys.
If Tom Brady plays for the next 2 years, he'd be number one.
I think he's retiring.
I know, but if he did, he'd be number one for sure.
Yeah. If he goes to another Super Bowl and wins it with the Buccaneers, he is number one. You cannot argue it.
How much does it change?
Do you actually know the stats of Buccaneers?
Huh?
Do you know what Buccaneers
How much
is?
Does that change? If you win what one changes? Now.
What do you mean?
That's what I'm trying to say. So, I think he's already kind of maxed out.
Yeah.
Well, it means he is 44 years old.
Yep.
And
when won
another Super Bowl.
When did Peyton Manning retire? 40?
40, 39 maybe. 40. 40.
40.
So,
depends if Tom Brady's getting burnt out.
Not yet. But I think it's also I think it's also the people around him.
Yeah.
That are helping him. I mean Gronk.
Gronk.
You know.
Not even Gronk, his full name.
Antonio Brown. Mike Evans. Scotty Scooter Miller, the legend himself.
What are these names, man? I don't know.
That's the Buccaneers announcer. He sounds like this when he's talking. He's like Scotty Scooter Miller in for the touchdown.
Ooh.
I'll have Noah play a Buccaneers radio call later. I don't know if we'll do it today, but maybe that'll be someone's one more thing. So let's keep going.
Number 5.
Yep,
is Walter Payton.
Never heard of him.
Oof. Yeah, this man's a legend. This man's a baller, like big baller more than all of them so far. I think this is fair on the list. Let's go to number 4. We gotta speed this up.
Okay, 4 is Jim Brown.
Okay. Okay.
Still never heard of him.
Yeah, he's from the 60s, so you wouldn't have.
I've only heard two.
Is O.J. Simpson on this list? Is he? He's in the top 10? Wow. Okay, so I guess you can...
No, he's not.
Okay, I was about to say. I was like, I guess murdering your wife doesn't affect your top 10 position. So, I hate ads. There's so many ads, guys. Okay, keep going. What's the next
one? YouTube.
Number 3 is Lawrence Taylor.
LT.
I will read you his stats.
Never heard of him.
Yeah.
2-time Super Bowl champion, 9-time first team All Pro selection, NFL MVP, and a 3-time NFL Defensive Player of the Year.
Yeah.
How is he voted the. What is it? Number 3?
Yeah.
How is he voted that?
Like a panel.
Is this a panel or is it like top 100 players, like NFL.com or whatever?
Panel. It's a panel. There's like.
It's not Ranker?
No.
Okay.
Boo, not Ranker.
Okay, so what's the next one?
Number 2.
He was good.
Is Tom Brady.
Okay.
Okay.
Who are they going to have above Brady?
I know him. Hey.
I don't know who they're going to have above Simpson. Brady. We've already discussed Brady a lot.
6-time Super Bowl champion, 4-time Super Bowl MVP, 3-time NFL MVP, and holds a plethora of Super Bowl records.
And he's really cool.
And he's
really popular.
And he's 44.
Yeah. Yeah, his stats are insane.
Actually, no. Now 7-time Super Bowl champion, 5-time Super Bowl MVP.
He wasn't the MVP last year.
Was it?
No.
Who was?
I forgot who it was, but it wasn't him. Music. I'm sorry. That was funny.
Wait.
He wasn't the
MVP.
Who
else could have been
the MVP? I don't know. It wasn't him, though. I remember being kind of surprised. Just, who's number 1?
Number 1 is Jerry Rice.
Really?
Rice? I love Rice.
Wow.
I mean,
the receiver gets number one. Huh. I disagree with that.
Heavily?
Yes, heavily. Because he was good, but he's a receiver, and receivers can't do anything. And he was
Is he top 10?
He was Joe Montana's receiver. Yes, he's top 10. But he was Joe Montana's receiver and Steve Young's receiver. So I give the credit more to the quarterbacks than the receivers because, well, the quarterback's passing to them. You can't really all the catches. So, yeah. I think that's going to be a
Actually, hold on, hold on.
Okay.
He was only Montana's receiver for, like,
a long time.
10 years.
Yes,
but then he played 10 more years after.
For Steve Young, who's also in the Hall of Fame.
It's true.
Exactly.
Okay, but let me read you some things. Three times Super Bowl champion, holds the NFL record in all-purpose touchdowns, total receptions, total receiving yards, and touchdown receptions.
Yeah, I know. I know. It sounds crazy. But he's a receiver. And I just don't think receivers can be the best player ever.
Mm.
It's not possible.
What's your top three?
Top three of all time?
Yeah.
Peyton Manning.
No, not number one. He's not number one.
Tom Brady, Peyton Manning.
Not even in my top three.
Dak Prescott. Dak Prescott, Peyton Manning, Ezekiel Elliott.
Sure. This is a tough one for me. I will go Walter Payton because the man was crazy. Walter Payton, Joe Montana, Tom Brady.
Great.
Yeah.
Number one is Tom Brady for me. That's about it. That's all I can
say. Okay. Well,
and then Peyton Manning because those are the only two I know. That are the greatest of all time.
Okay. Well, I think that's going to do it for this segment. Coming up next, we just got time for one more thing. We'll do it right after this.
If you are craving some fried rice, egg rolls, boba tea, beef teriyaki, or my favorite, sesame chicken, then Hannah's Cafe and Market is for you. It's the newest restaurant in town, and for all you Bulldogs, there is a 10% student discount for a limited time. Hannah's Cafe and Market is located at 105 South Denny Street in Howe, just north of the First Baptist Church. You can find them on Facebook or call at 903-532-0529. Hannah's Cafe and Market. Go Dogs!
JA Autos is the one and only used car lot in Howe. Along with used cars, they sell custom trailers and food trucks that are built to your needs. Is that not cool or what? Not only do they sell custom trailers and food trucks, but they also sell used cars that look practically new and are easily affordable. JA Autos also has a YouTube channel called JA Autos and Food Trailers, in all caps. His channel gives you a personal tour of the trailers and cars that are sold there. You can find JA Autos at 412 West Hanning Street. Their phone number is 903-744-5650. Once again, that's 412 West Hanning Street, and their number is 903-744-5650.
Welcome back to the Howe Podcast 101. I am your co-host, Jake Roberts, joined alongside
other co-host, Lucas Mitchell, and joined by our engineer,
Noah Riley, who didn't use his camera all day, and we're very disappointed in him. And with that being said, we just got time for one more thing.
I forgot. There is one more thing.
Gentlemen, one more thing, guys.
I can't with that intro. Beetle, that's like...
Gentlemen.
What do you mean? It's awesome.
You need to do it in a deeper voice next time.
Gentlemen.
So it's even funnier.
One more thing.
Yeah, it's epic. I love the one more thing music. It's just like... Okay, who wants to go first today?
I'll go first.
Go ahead.
Okay.
You're bad.
So, do y'all know those giant wind turbines?
We
those,
do.
No,
those
I don't.
Those big old white wind turbines in West Texas.
Yeah.
And in Oklahoma.
In Oklahoma.
Yeah.
Like, where it's windy.
Yeah.
So, you know those things kill about 328,000 birds a year?
I get
that. I mean, it makes sense. Because birds are stupid.
Yeah.
And they, like, land on the turbines and then get whacked by them.
Yeah.
Idiots.
It almost feels like they actually would die of frostbite, practically. Because if they sit up there and it's, like, really cold up there. And
true.
They would freeze to death on it.
They could.
That's slightly logical.
I think I
I think me and Noah are both kind of at a loss here on what that means.
The reason why I say that is because I remember something saying that they actually die from the cold while they're up there. Usually.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, we both have the same one more thing. So, those of you who don't know, and you have to be living under a rock to not know, Alec Baldwin shot a man. He, did you know? Did you hear about the story, Noah?
No.
Really? Wow, you're living under a rock. So, the actor, Alec Baldwin, right?
Yeah.
He shot on set a person. Shot and killed on set a famous cinematographer. Not famous, but an award-winning cinematographer.
Yeah.
Wasn't his fault. People are still kind of confused about whose fault it is.
It
could have been his fault, I guess. But he was handed...
There's
prop guns, right? That are supposed to have casings that pop out to make it look dramatic. Well, someone loaded a real bullet inside of it.
One of the
just like a real genius.
So
for the scene,
weird.
He was shooting it, right? Because it was part of the scene, and he shot her in the chest.
Well, I think it was actually I think it was just on accident. I don't think they were doing a scene. Were they?
No, not yet.
Yeah, they weren't doing a scene.
It was before a scene.
But
he was just messing around because, well, I mean, it's a prop gun. Who doesn't mess around with a prop gun?
True.
Right. And he like...
I mean, it's technically a real gun with a blank
with,
in it.
With casing. With blank casing.
Which they thought was a blank in it.
And it shot her and killed her. And this is all over the news right now. It's everywhere. And I'm kind of confused on how it happened. I wish more details would come out because there's really not many.
Apparently, I don't know, I heard a rumor about... the armorer and Alec Baldwin already having an affair before. You know what I mean? Like a disagreement or something like that. And I guess that's being told draft court or something like
that. Wow. Okay. Things get interesting very quickly.
Yeah.
Is that...
very weird.
That was fast. That's our one more thing.
Pretty much.
So...
also, like, subscribe, hit the notification button before you miss another thing, and then share and comment and blah, blah, blah.
My mic wasn't working for a second. Sorry, guys. So, is that going to do it for the show? Thank you so much for watching, if you got to this point especially. Comment down below if you got to this point. We'll give you a free water bottle, because no one ever gets to this point. I'd be shocked if anyone got to this point. Noah, if you tell anyone to go to this point to get a free water bottle, you're fired.
Deal.
For me, Jake Roberts.
And for me, Mitchell.
And for me, Noah. We're signing off now.